Hi, good day to all. You know, we are stuck in our homes. Educational systems and establishments have undergone a tremendous change. Most of us, like me, teachers, actually are forced to transform, metamorphosize into something which we were not before. As you know very well, the online or e-learning is taking upper hand these days. E-learning is taking upper hand, and teachers are sitting at home, and even students are sitting at home. So our home or our rooms are being changed into classrooms. Natural, that's a natural result because we cannot go out. We do not know how long this real virtual classrooms will last. We do not know when this pandemic is going to end. So then the teachers are faced with a dilemma. The teachers are faced with the confusion that, okay, regular classing, live classes, all those things can happen in e-learning, then how to conduct examinations? So, dear friends and teachers, in this class, I'm going to tell you the step-by-step instruction how to conduct an online test. If you do it in the proper way, by enabling or disabling certain functions, I think it's going to be as effective as the regular traditional classroom examinations. So we have different methods and softwares for that. The one thing which I'm going to tell you is Microsoft Forms. So friends, welcome to this training session of how to conduct examination using Microsoft Forms. So, friends, it's easy to do in a desktop, but here we are going to focus on how to do it in an Android device or a mobile phone. You know, first thing, if you're using Microsoft Teams as a platform for education, because in my school it is used as a platform, because I am addressing my teachers specifically in this class. So, when you open the step number one that you need to do, is you open Microsoft Teams. You can straight away go to Forms as well, but it's easier because since you have been using Forms all throughout, you open Microsoft Teams, step number one. Then on the bottom, you can see those, okay, the menu bar at the bottom is files, posts, calendar, assignments. Step number two, you click on the assignments. You can see the screen. Step number two, first you get the screen, assignments, and you click on assignments. Once you click the assignment, you will be prompted, will be asked to select a class. You select a class where you teach, where you are the teacher of that particular class. Then you select that class, step number, after when you get selected, you select that class, then you have to, you have to go to the next section. Next, step number three is on top of the screen, you can see here, you come to Forms, new quiz. You have to click on new quiz, there's a plus symbol on top. You click on that plus symbol. Then you are directed to go to Forms, that is the Microsoft Forms out of Teams. And when you reach Microsoft Forms, again you can see two options. That is new quiz, new forms on top and new quiz below. So the next step you need to do is click on new quiz. You can see an untitled form appear. The untitled form is placed. You click on the untitled, you can give the name first term examinations Malayalam. The description part below it, you can give the description for it is your school. Okay, you can see the name of the school, if it is Merigiri English Medium School, Srikandapuram, general instructions that you give for the text. All these things can be given there. And after that, you can add questions place. You can either select MCQ for multiple choice, or the second option is for text ABC for, if you want to give short and long answers, you can click on that. If it is an MCQ, multiple choice, You type the questions at the designated place where the question is to be typed. And then option number one, you can type what is the option there. Option number two, you can again type what's the option there. If you want more options, you can click add option, write the third option. Again, you click if add option. If you want the fourth one, then type the fourth option. And you can see a tick mark along with each option. If you think which is the right answer, you click on the tick. Again, it's the right answer. Again, it's the option. The system will check the answers itself. Then below that, you can see a point section, a box, where you can add the marks there. If it's one mark or two mark, whatever marks you want to get. Then again, you click on to add question. You keep on adding questions like that. And once you completed creating your questions, on the side, you can see two options, preview. Then you can see how it looks like when the students open. And theme, you can create some background pictures. And you can even upload your own pictures as a background. You can create a classroom situation if you want. Then you can see there's three dots on the, right hand side of the screen is where you click, you get the settings option. When you click on the settings option, first thing is that there is an option, allow students to see the answers when submit. You disable it, because if students see the marks at that time when they submit, it may create examination malpractice. So let us disable it, then leave the rest as it is, don't change anything. You come to the part that starting date and time, ending date and time, you can set the date and time of the examination to start and when to end. The form will only open at that time. Then shuffle questions option below that. You click on shuffle questions so that you can, so the students get different sets. First question of one student may not be the first question of other, so it's shuffled. That is also keeping the secrecy and the authenticity of the examination in mind. And having done that, you go and click on the share button on top. You can see a link is generated. A link is generated. You click on copy. You copy it. Then you close the, you come back to, that means you close the forms, you come back. You come to Teams, you take your team class where you want to conduct the examination. For example, if you want to do it, it's 12C. You click on 12C general. And there, in pause, we can paste this link. And students, when they click on this link before the time, they can only see this form is not accepting any response. That is what they see. Only when the time comes, the forms will open. They can conduct the examination and they submit the papers in time. If they do it later, they won't be able to submit. Within the time frame, they need to submit. And once having done that, having submitted the paper, teachers need to go to forms again. Where you created this question paper, you can see this question paper is already there. You click on the right side, you can see response. Click on that, you can see how many students and what answers they did. You may open it in MS Excel file and you can check log answers and add the marks to already added multiple choice marks. So it becomes child's play. So hope you understood how to conduct an examination. And once you do it, try it, it becomes very simple. It is easier and more convenient for teachers than the traditional regular classroom examination. Let us hope for the best. Thank you.